I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
So Robert, Mikey has a lot of options from 135 to 147. But first, Lipinets 140, March 10th.
140, yeah, and hopefully by the summer, hopefully, which would really not be fun, because that's a fight that not only Mikey, but me, I think that's the fight that makes the most sense, especially here in Southern California.
But Linares has to win Saturday. If he loses,
he should win.
Against Marcito Hesta.
Mikey has to win also, you know,
you're right,
for the fight to be big. Because Mikey could, if Mikey loses to Lipinets, Mikey could still go down to 135 and still win.
He's still a champion. Yeah.
But it's still not going to be, it'll still be coming from off a loss. It doesn't, just doesn't mean the same.
Linares,
they both have to win.
Has fast hands. He's an experienced champion.
Skills, one of the best.
Josecito,
yeah.
Everybody, look out for Josecito Lopez at Jose Lopez.
At Jose Lopez.
You're fighting on Mikey Garcia card against
March
Hector
10.
Munoz.
March 10.
March 10, yep.
So this week is taking it easy. Next week
back to a real workout, sparring area.
What do you like best about sparring Brandon?
It's fun, man. He's
funny?
He's a vet, so you know, any little tricks there is, he's going to use them. So I love it.
Brandon's been here. He's coming.
Sparred 12 rounds today.
How do you do? Today? Monday?
Yeah, 12 rounds. Because he's not gonna. Because we're not gonna do Wednesday.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
that's
yeah.
Why he came today.
He did good.
Yeah, 12 rounds. Brandon always sparred. Brandon.
He's on weight. He's happy.
He's, you know, he's one thing I've never seen that with him. We still got what, like 3 weeks.
To 4 weeks.
Almost 4 weeks for his
Wait, for the 17th, right?
Yeah, the 17th.
One, so three and a half, yeah.
3.5 weeks, and he's only like 7 or 8 pounds overweight.
That's good.
I've never seen that in Brandon. That's good, really good. So, he's got a really good shot at cleaning it up. I think so.
It's, your dad told me he wins by knockout.
If it's by knockout, it'll be late in the rounds.
But you're confident. You like the way what you're saying. I mean, Danny's a talented fighter as well. It's a very high level fight.
Yeah.
It's championship level. Is there any belts on the line?
I think they're doing it for the
Eliminator
or something like
for
that.
For Thurman's belt, correct?
Yes, the OBC.
Which Thurman has it.
Yes.
So the winner could fight for the title.
Yes.
Now, Sean Porter told me he's going to be ringside because he wants to fight Danny.
Mm-hmm.
He gave Brandon, he said Brandon has zero chance of winning.
He did?
Yeah, but he said no chance at all. But everybody has a chance. It's boxing.
Yeah. But Sean Porter, you know what? Sean Porter's the fighter that Danny, Brandon, Keith Thurman, even though Keith Thurman already fought him, but that he's the one that most of them try to avoid because of the style. He's very difficult, very tough. So it won't be a pretty fight, and there's a big chance you're going to lose that fight. Against Sean Porter. Sean Porter was always, see, sometimes a lot of us, because I'm one of them, we pick the other guy to win because they got more skills. But Sean Porter's style is the style that makes everyone.
How about Agus Kavalausko, Sean Porter? 147. You like Sean Porter?
Oh, man, this fucker's too strong for these guys.
Let's fight.
Let's fight. Robert said he's one fighter people don't like is the style.
Yeah, style. He's too awkward. He just goes in.
He's in your face.
But he just has the power to finish him off.
See you Friday.
Friday.
Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best. Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future. We don't lose. Tell me what you're watching. EsNews. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind, competition, he abusing them.